This is my favorite shot from the Grand Budapest Hotel. Wes Anderson's style is often first identified as clean and precise. His characters move in straight lines and turn at right angles through dollhouse sets. But is this absolute control what marks his talent? Well, no, at least not entirely.
She's been murdered, and you think I did it.
He has this underrated power in the times he clomps through the playhouse he's built, with either moments of chaos or pathos that hit harder because of the contrast. I'm talking about Wes Anderson in a video about a very different movie because he's someone who you could take the wrong lesson from, that being a good director means exercising complete control over everything, when even he gets some of his best moments from giving control up to chaos. Anora is at the opposite end of the spectrum. The movie is a near non-stop parade of dancing, arguing, partying, fucking, drinking, and barefisted brawling. And though much of the joy is watching the characters and plot spin out of control in unison, it still all manages to fall into place beautifully. About a third in, I mistakenly thought this meant the movie had gotten away from Sean Baker, but I was so wrong. Anora follows Annie, a sex worker who enters a whirlwind romance with Ivan, the rich son of a Russian oligarch. It is a movie about a specific kind of chaos, the chaos you are allowed to leave in your wake when you have the money to pay for it. The money Annie must work all night for before returning home exhausted to a small apartment she shares with her sister, and the money Ivan is able to spend on penthouse suites he leaves trash the next day with money given to him by birthright. There are a lot of chaotic scenes, and what took a while to sink in for me was that even though there would sometimes be two or three people talking at the same time, sometimes in different languages with subtitles, people would be hitting each other, breaking things, and running around, and still I could perfectly understand what was going on. And little bits of humor that I thought were just juvenile or cheap slapstick would come around as incredibly profound character moments. Mikey Madison as Annie is fantastic, channeling hunger for the life her and Yvonne have together and the determination not to let anyone take it away. She's already the frontrunner in the Oscar race, as is the film in general for Best Picture. Both are immensely deserving, and I'm really happy that a movie humanizing sex workers that took the care to actually involve people with intimate knowledge is getting this much attention. For The Kit, Andrew Awerhun, a sex work consultant on the film, wrote that Sean Baker has managed to defy tired stereotypes by paying sex workers to check his work. The result is a must-see portrayal of sex work that is both rare and riveting. She also expresses a desire to see more sex workers telling their own stories, and it looks like one of her own books is being turned into a movie. I would recommend seeing Anora in theaters. It's the kind of quality movie that deserves attention in this clusterfuck of an industry. You'll have a great time with it, and folks are going to be discussing it for a good while. Thanks for watching.